Hi, good morning. Today we're going to be looking at the element of art that is called form. And what form is the representation of things in three dimensions. So if a shape has two dimensions of height and width, form has three dimensions: height, width, and depth. Now, we will be working mostly with drawing. So we need to create the illusion of form. And how do we do that? Well, there are a couple of ways, and I am going to start with the most obvious or the most basic. We're going to draw a line on our screen and we're going to put a dot. Okay. This is called the horizon line, and the dot is called our vanishing point. And now we are going to start, as all artwork does, by drawing a line. And we're going to join up some lines. Okay. Now I am going to close this particular shape. Okay. Below the horizon line, just to make this a little easier for us. And what we will do is, from one of the corners, we are going to draw a straight line to the vanishing point. From this corner, we are going to draw another line to the vanishing point. Okay? Most things in the real world don't extend to the vanishing point, so I am going to draw a straight line here to mark the end of the particular form that I am working with. And then I will go in with an eraser and erase all the lines I don't need. Okay, there's my vanishing point. So that's one way of creating the illusion of form. But what happens if I'm working with something that is an organic shape? Okay, the exact same things apply. I am going to find an edge of a shape, okay, and I'm going to again line up to the vanishing point. Now, to prevent too many lines from happening, I am going to say, here we go, okay? So if you can't see that, and I can't, okay, there's my line. I'm going to find another point or edge on this organic shape, and again drawing that line. Then from the top, okay, now the tricky part here is to line up the shape. I can't just draw a straight line between these. I have to respect the fact that this is curved, so I will just curve this. Here again, we have a strange shape. Okay, so I am again going to follow the shape of the original article. Okay, so I've now created some 3D objects using nothing but my horizon line and my vanishing point. Okay, I can also move a shape above the horizon line. So here I am quickly sketching out a rectangle. Okay, I'm working with very basic shapes. Okay, so I find my corner, I find my vanishing point, and there we go. Okay, again, I'm not taking the line all the way to the vanishing point. Okay, this is where having a ruler comes in incredibly handy. I am also going to use this, and again, okay. Now, I decide how deep my shape is, and I am going to, this is a straight and horizontal line. This, obviously, I need to match up. So, there we go. Okay, and I am going to go back in and get rid of any excess lines. And here we go. We have a box or a cube that is floating above our horizon line. Okay, but works with the vanishing point. Okay, so that's the beginning of working with form. I hope this has been informative.